3, 2, 1.
Harry Jerome, Lincoln Alexander, Harriet Tubman, and Elijah McCoy. We all know and have heard of these leaders and figures. But what about Portia White, James Mink, Anderson Ruffin Abbott, and Kay Livingston? What are their stories, histories, and struggles? Many, if not all of these figures, started from nothing. And often, as a people, it appears our destiny is to start from nothing and yet rise to something. So here is your challenge. How do you start with nothing? Where is your destiny? And how will you rise and offer yourself? Take your place in the pages of Canadian history. How will you ensure that your history is not misplaced? Portia White was a school teacher turned concert singer. James Mink was the son of former Canadian slaves who became one of Toronto's wealthiest blacks in the 1840s. Kay Livingston was an actress who went on to coin the term visible minority groups. And Anderson Ruffin Abbott was a descendant of former slaves who went on to become the first Canadian-born black doctor.
Josiah Henson was the first black Canadian of national and international importance. Born into slavery on June 15, 1789 in Maryland, he escaped to freedom in Upper Canada with his wife and children in 1930. Josiah helped to settle the Dawn Settlement near Chatham, Ontario, and established the British American Institute, which provided students with training in various trades. An instrumental figure in the black community, Josiah encouraged self-reliance and lectured about the business of crops, wages, and profits. He constantly emphasized that the black community needed two things to prosper: land and education. The Dawn Settlement had its problems. Money and disagreement among the leadership was at the forefront. In 1868, the institute was finally closed, and the proceeds from selling the land were used to set up a new institute, the Wilberforce Educational Institute for Black and White Children. Josiah Henson became a historical figure in the white and African communities of Canada. His fame in his later life was due to his character portrayal in a book by Harriet Beecher Stowe called Uncle Tom's Cabin. The name, Uncle Tom, followed Josiah Henson for the rest of his life. However, legend should not be permitted to obscure the character and the accomplishments of the real man. Josiah Henson was not an Uncle Tom. Ever wonder how cabs came to Toronto? Interestingly enough, the first cab was actually a horse-drawn carriage that was designed, built, and operated by Thornton Blackburn. A former slave, Blackburn, along with his wife Lucy, escaped to Toronto from Kentucky in order to escape re-enslavement. That's right, re-enslavement. Observing Montreal's more efficient public transportation system, Blackburn decided to model Toronto's in that image. In 1837, the first cab was issued, complete with the yellow and red colors, and was named The City.
Many people immigrated from the Caribbean with the hopes of making a better life for themselves.
One of the few available employment options for Caribbean women was domestic work, leaving many on the outskirts of Canadian society. To many of us, this may seem as a dead-end option. However, one woman was able to have an impact. Eva Smith was born in Rio Bueno, Jamaica on March 1, 1923 and immigrated to Canada in 1956. She became a tireless campaigner on the behalf of not only the youth within Toronto's Caribbean population, but mainstream society as well. Her selfless commitment to the youth has been recognized by the Ujamaa Youth Group through the annual Eva Smith Bursary and in North York by Eva's Place, a 30-bed wheelchair-accessible residence for homeless young people ages 16 to 21.
Blood, it's new to give. Does this sound familiar? 1 in 20 North Americans will require a blood transfusion at some point in their lives. We owe much to Charles Richard Drew, a pioneer in blood research. Charles obtained his medical degree from McGill University in 1933. He then interned in Montreal General, where he further researched into the field of blood preservation. In 1935, he taught pathology at Howard University, but it was at Columbia that he made his mark. While at Columbia Medical Center, Charles found that blood plasma could replace whole blood in transfusions, a remarkable medical breakthrough. He went on to receive an honorary Doctor of Science degree from Columbia University and served as director of the American Red Cross Blood Donor Project during the Second World War. He also served as assistant director of blood processing on the National Research Council. On April 1st, 1950, Charles Richard Drew was involved in a car accident in North Carolina. He was minutes away from White Hospital, but was denied entry because of the color of his skin. On his way to a Negro hospital miles away, he bled to death.
I know we're all familiar with Rosa Parks, but 10 years before Rosa, there was Viola Desmond, an African-Canadian beautician and teacher from Halifax, Nova Scotia. On November 8, 1946, Viola was caught in a blizzard and decided to pass the time at the local Roseland Theater. While she requested for a ticket for house seats, the teller instead sold her a balcony seat, which was where the black people in that town sat. Viola chose to sit in the house seats, which were the whites' only seats, and when she refused to move, the manager called the police. She was thrown in jail for 12 hours and was charged with attempting to defraud the federal government based on her refusal to pay the 1 cent amusement tax difference between the 3 cents charged to those sitting in the balcony and the 2 cents charged to those sitting downstairs. When Viola offered to pay the difference in ticket price, she was refused and was charged a fine of $20 and 30 days in jail. The Nova Scotia Association for the Advancement of Colored People appealed to the Supreme Court, but lost on the technicality. Viola's resistance was not in vain, however. In 1954, the Nova Scotia government repealed the laws allowing segregation. The Elgin settlement was literally the last stop on the Underground Railway. It was founded by a white Presbyterian minister by the name of Reverend William King, who was against slavery, believing that education is the grand lever whereby to elevate mankind to a high moral standard. By freeing his slaves from his Louisiana plantation in 1846, he took them to Kent County, near Chatham, Ontario, intending it to be the starting point of an all-black colony of fugitive slaves, hoping to prove the truth of his outspoken beliefs. At the height of its prosperity, Elgin became a sufficient community for 1,200 to 2,000 people and was built around an agricultural economy, and later branched out to include entrepreneur ventures such as blacksmiths, hotels, and industrial ventures that allowed them to establish and assert their economic independence. Furthermore, the construction of the Cross Canada Railway provided employment for many of these settlers, which enabled them to eventually purchase the Elgin settlement. This, however, meant little to the opponents of equality, as political and racial attacks against this new community were rampant and was soon the focus of the struggle between opponents and supporters of racism in Chatham and Ontario in general. From threats of lowered land values to the provincial tax poll, a tax only for blacks, Elgin was the forefront of resistance, both implicit and explicit. As you have seen, African Canadians have played a prominent role in the making of Canada. You too can leave your mark on the pages of Canadian society. It is unfortunate that this information has been omitted from the pages of history. To ensure that all students are informed about these issues, you must demand that your teachers talk to you about the contributions of Africans to our society and to discuss issues that are relevant to you. It is your right as a Canadian citizen. It is your right as a citizen of the world. You can learn more about the contributions of African Canadians through various books or research on the internet. Remember, to know where you're going, you have to know where and how far you've come. I'm embracing, wipe the sweat off my dome, spit the phlegm on the streets. Sway Tim's on my beats, makes my cypher complete. Weather cruising in a six cab, I'm on tarot deep, I can't call it. The beats make me falling asleep, I keep falling. We're never falling 6 feet deep, I'm out for presidents to represent me. Say what? I'm out for presidents to represent me. Say what? I'm out for dead presidents to represent me. Me.
World is this?
The world is yours, the world is yours.
Smartest mind,
the world is yours, the world is yours.
Smartest mind, the world is yours. yours. The world is yours.
It's mine, it's mine, it's mine.
To my man, ill will, God bless your life. To my people's the wild.